Some good news now for motorists. Oil prices headed lower next week. Estimates show a liter of gasoline would be cheaper by up to 80 centavos. Or make that 60 centavos after its price went up by 50 centavos this week. The prices of diesel and kerosene, meanwhile, are seen to go down by at least 10 centavos. Filipino commuters worried over the impending 5-year closure of the Philippine National Railways operations of the train line that will be suspended to make way for the construction of the north-to-south commuter railway. Jervis Manahan reports.
Starting March 28 of this year, the Metro Manila operations of the Philippine National Railways will temporarily stop. This is to give way to the construction of the north-to-south commuter railways, which will run from Pampanga to Laguna. The country's transportation department says it would be dangerous to continue the train's operations while construction of the elevated railway is ongoing. Unfortunately for those using the PNR, the train service won't be available for 5 years. But once they resume operations, a better commuter experience is expected, with modern coaches, a signaling system, and more frequent trips. To accommodate affected passengers, the DOTR will deploy an initial batch of 25 buses near the PNR train stations. But passengers who commute daily are worried since bus fares cost more.
Malaking hassle kasi everyday traffic, pag nag-commute kami ng jeep. Pag mag-commute kasi kami, tatlong jeep, isang LRT. Pero pag PNR, isang PNR, isang jeep lang.
Sa 25 pesos, napakalaking bagay po sa amin dahil yung sobra nun siyang ginagastos pa namin.
Transportation Group Alt Mobility PH also voiced their reservation for the plan, saying the bus replacements cannot stand on its own. They say it must be complemented by dedicated bus lanes to offer the same efficiency and timetable offered by the train service. The group adds there should also be improved pedestrian and transit facilities, especially for stops farther than 300 meters. Once the PNR stops operations in Manila, the trains will be relocated to the PNR operations in the south, particularly in Quezon and the Bicol region. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
As the Philippines celebrates Women's Month, one of the remarkable female leaders in the tech field hails women's capability in managing multiple roles in society. Speaking to ANC's Business Outlook, NetTrust Philippines Chairwoman and CEO and mother of four, Jen Capones Tongco, asserts women can thrive both at home and in workplaces without feeling like they should be confined to one role.
You don't need to choose. You can have both ambition in terms of whatever fuels your passion in terms of your ambition. And being a mom, I think it's really more of understanding that we cannot do it all. Mm-hmm. Right? Because sometimes women are hard on themselves, saying that, you know, I have to do it all. And that's the reason why that stops them from doing what they want to do. There are so many things that people may say. And the way for me to move forward and to be able to have success is not to really mind all these things, but control what I can control, which means taking charge of my career or what I can do, founding my own company, taking the seat on the table.
The Philippine Health Department intensifies its efforts to apprehend vape sellers who sell their products to minors. Although supportive of this move, the Vapers Alliance says online stores where transactions are not usually traced must also be monitored. Rafael Bosano reports.
Call yourself stubborn if you're a minor and would still attempt to buy vape products from this store. This big poster in a Quezon City vape shop should be enough to ward off any minors who will attempt to buy their products. But a store personnel admits some still choose to ignore it.
Pag duda po kami sa itsura, hinihingan po namin ang ID. Then pag hindi po sila nakapag-provide, di po namin sila pagbebenta.
Ikatwiran ng bata na inutusan
hindi
lang
sila. Hindi po talaga pwede. Hindi po namin pagbibilan.
Vape shops selling their products to minors will soon find themselves in hot water. This after the Philippine Health Department asked for the Philippine National Police's help in apprehending unscrupulous sellers who prioritize profit over the youth's welfare.
Sa pang-invalid defense, Hindi naman para sa kanya yung pagbili, ngunit para sa ibang tao. It is the duty of the seller to actually check kung kailangan humingi ng ID. Patingin ng ID mo, Toy, ilang taon ka na. At hindi pwedeng excuse yun na parang, mukha naman siyang matanda. No, that's not acceptable, sabi ng PNP.
The Vapors Alliance expressed support for this move. In fact, they are also discouraging the youth from trying out vape products.
Hindi ginawa itong produktong ito para magamit ng mga minor de edad, bagkos ito ay ginawa para makatulong dun sa mga currently na naninigarilyo. Madiin po nating pinapaalala sa ating mga kabataan na iwasan itong produktong ito.
But they also appeal to authorities to monitor online stores where transactions are much faster and easier.
Siguro mas maganda i-suggest natin na ang tingnan ng ating mga kapulisan at ng DOH is yung mga nabibenta online. Kasi yung mga online na vapor products na nabibenta are pretty much unregulated. I mean, hindi natin masyadong natitrace itong mga transactions na to.
The PNP is even looking at how to do it, how to implement when it comes to online. Sabi niya, this is also on our radar at inaaral na namin paano mang-aresto or mag-implement when it comes to online violations.
The DOH says, just like cigarettes, vape products have also been seen to pose negative effects on one's lungs. Domingo explains among the ill effects is the decline of the lung's elasticity, causing difficulties in breathing in the long run. Studies have also linked vape products to e-cigarette and vape-associated lung injuries or EVALI. Data from the Global Youth Tobacco Survey showed that in 2019, one out of every seven children aged 13 to 15 years used electronic cigarettes. In 2015, first-time users of electronic cigarettes is one out of every 10 kids aged 13 to 15 years. This figure rose to one out of every four years later. The DOH explains there are a myriad of other ways to relax and bust stress. Among them, exercising, which releases dopamine, known better as happy hormones. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Former Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte has been appointed property administrator of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, the religious group led by his spiritual advisor, Pastor Apollo Quiboloy. Duterte's new role was announced by the religious group's media arm, SMNI. It did not offer any details of Duterte's new responsibilities. ANC has yet to receive a comment from Duterte's camp. The legal camp of embattled televangelist Apollo Quiboloy writes to the House Committee on Legislative Franchises that their client does not have the information the panel needs in its hearings. The lawyers, led by attorney Ferdinando Pacho, are responding to a subpoena issued by the panel to compel Quiboloy to attend the congressional investigation into the alleged franchise violations of SMNI. They sought to clarify Quiboloy has not been involved in the management and operations of SMNI since 2018. They add the only title Quiboloy holds is the company honorary chairman, which they insist is purely honorific in character. Now, the House panel's chairman, Gustavo Tambunting, however, said it is within the discretion of Congress to subpoena any person it believes can best answer the questions poised in the inquiry. The committee resumes its hearings on March 12. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department reveals more details of the upcoming trip of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to Germany and the Czech Republic next week. Our correspondent, Joyce Balanzo, joins us on the line with that story. Hi, Joyce.
Hi, Stanley. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will depart on Monday for a working visit to Germany on March 12 to 13 to be followed by a state visit to the Czech Republic on the 14th up to the 15th. The president will meet with German Chancellor Olaf Scholz in Berlin, while in the Czech Republic, he will meet with the four heads of the Czech government, including its prime minister, the parliament senate president, and the president of Chamber of Deputies. Department of Foreign Affairs Assistant Secretary Maria Elena Algabe said his trip seeks to strengthen bilateral relations and foster increased cooperation with the two nations. Now, several agreements are expected to be sealed during the president's visit to Germany, including a cooperation in the maritime sector as well as technical and vocational education and training. While in the Czech Republic, President Marcos is expected to witness the signing of a joint communique on the establishment of labor consultations mechanism. Now, this aims to enhance cooperation for the safe and orderly migration of Filipino workers, as well as protection of their rights and welfare. DFA said there are around 7,000 Filipinos in the Czech Republic, and the government there has expressed great interest to invite more Filipinos as they commend them for their talent, skills, good work ethics, and hospitable nature. Possible discussions on rules-based international order as well as the South China Sea issue are also possible with the leaders of the two countries. Asika Algabre said Philippines has an existing maritime cooperation with Germany, and it is expected that the two nations will discuss further expansion of that cooperation. President Marcos Stanley will also meet with prominent business leaders in both countries to bolster trade and investment opportunities. There will be meetings with companies that are in the renewable energy, manufacturing, healthcare, aerospace, and innovation. Now, just like in his previous foreign travels, Marcos Jr. is also expected to face the Filipino communities living in Germany and the Czech Republic to personally share his administration's plans and programs for the OFWs and to reaffirm the government's commitment to continuously support Filipinos worldwide. Pala said the two visits coincide with the celebration of the 70th anniversary of diplomatic relations with Germany this year and the 50th anniversary of bilateral relations with the Czech Republic last year. The president will be joined by First Lady Liza Marcos, House Speaker Martin Romualdez, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, and some key cabinet officials, including Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo, Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual, Agriculture Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel, Migrant Workers Officer in Charge Hans Leo Cacdac, among others. Tani?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Joyce Balancho. An analyst warns China could further its bid to conquer the South China Sea. Renato De Castro says Beijing may display more acts of aggression as it aims to expand its maritime territory. De Castro adds China is out to show it is more powerful than the U.S. because of its larger Navy fleet.
Bakit po napakalakas ng loob ng China dyan? Sa ngayon ho, ang China ho ang merong pinakamalaking Navy. Nahuho nila ang Estados Unidos. Meron na ho sila around 450 ships ng People's Liberation Army's Navy. Samantala ang Estados Unidos ho, nasa mga 250 lang. Kaya napakalakas ho talaga ng loob nila. Itong nakaraang araw lang ho, in-announce ho, meron ng Party Congress na nangyayari. Doon sa Party Congress ho, pinulong ho ni President Xi Jinping yung Military Commission, yung member ng Military Commission, at sinabi niya, maghanda tayo sa digmaan sa karagatan. Pananakop po ng China, dapat paalisin ho nila lahat yung mga barko dyan, ng Philippine Navy, ating mga mangisda, and even yung Coast Guard natin. So nakikita natin talaga yung tinutuloy ho nila, yung kanilang objective is of course maritime expansion.
Despite this, De Castro says the Philippines should just continue its transparency initiatives to show that Manila is standing up against Beijing's aggression.
Dapat ho natin ituloy kasi pag hindi ho natin ituloy yan, tinatanggap ho natin yung pananakop po nila. Kumbaga, we agree na kanila yan. At of course, hindi rin tayo papayag ho na humingi sa kanila ng permission. We have to assert yung karapatan natin as provided by UNCLOS at ipamukha rin ho sa buong mundo na hindi natin tinatanggap at dapat rin ho nila hindi tanggapin yung pananakop po ng China. Kasi pag bumigay ho tayo, sasabihin ho ng buong mundo, oh, tinanggap nyo na yung pananakop ng China, di ano pa magagawa natin?
The Philippine Coast Guard accusing its Chinese counterpart of spreading propaganda over the latest maritime incident in the West Philippine Sea. PCG spokesperson Jay Tariela said Chinese Coast Guard personnel were taking videos of the collision between Manila and Beijing's ships. He suspects this is not just for documentation, and the Chinese want to make it look like the Philippine vessel was the one that rammed onto the Chinese ship. But Tariela insists it is China who is repeatedly harassing contingents of Philippine resupply missions. The latest Chinese aggression, which occurred early this week, resulted in injuries of 4 Philippine Navy personnel and damage to 2 ships.
Despite of all this provocation na na-document natin, sinapubliko natin, and it was also captured by the international media, and yet, ang Chinese government, sila pa ngayon nagpapalabas na we are the ones na nag-escalate ng tension, nag-trespass daw. This is the reason why the Philippine government is really doing its effort in our transparency strategy.
Retrieval efforts underway for the bodies of two Filipinos and another sailor from a ship set ablaze by a Houthi missile attack in the Gulf of Aden. The operations are led by International Maritime Security Forces, which are being closely watched by the Philippine Migrant Workers Department. Philippine officials, however, admit it is challenging to recover the bodies.
Magiging hamon din yung pag-recover ng labi. Kaya pagdarasal pa rin natin na maisagawa ito ng maayos.
We're not sure about the final plan kung paano kukunin. By the way, responsibility is the mining agency. They have to find a way to get this. Na-inform na yung pamilya pero wala pa tayong permission na bigay. No? Ang sabi ko lang, tika-antike at Caloocan sila.
The Iran-backed rebel group launched its first fatal attack on a commercial ship in the Gulf of Aden Wednesday. Authorities confirmed 13 other Filipino seafarers who were on board when the strike happened are now in good condition. The group of local manning agencies slams a series of attacks in the Red Sea, which it says continuously threaten the lives of seafarers.
We condemn these attacks by the Houthis on commercial shipping. The longer route is from Europe going down to South Africa, which takes about 10 more days. So ang consequence niyan, tataas ang insurance ng barko, tataas ang cost of products, cost of delivery,